La que voy a subir ahora es esta. Ready. Esto y esto. Ok, ya empieza a ser carito. Son 10k.
Madre mía, ¿por qué tanto dinero?
Why am I doing this? This is just a waste of money, you know? Es una pérdida de dinero. Yo lo hago por los loles. Let's go. Ok, chat me va a avisar, ok. Chat me avisa. Voy, voy. Por favor. Por favor. Uno. Dos. Tres. Off. 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 Mira, no me utilizó los dos. No me utilizó los dos. Uy. ¿Sabe qué quiere decir eso? ¿Sabe qué quiere decir esto? Tier 3. Are you ready? 20KK. Oh my god. 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 Ok, me tapo, me tapo. ¡Uy! Pero. Fantamalaxe tier 3. Tier 3, imbuida. Mana Leech. Vamos a comprar los bichos estos. Oh my god. Ahora falta la Herb Mail. Y luego los Terra Helme. Y luego, no sé. You're gonna try tier 4. You cannot do tier 4. It's the maximum for this class item. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ok. Tier 3. Tier 3. Es más, vamos a quitar esta porque I already have my Tier 3 weapon. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ok, let's refill because I wanna try this weapon. Let's go hunting. Let's go flimsies. Let's go to flimsies. I wanna try this. I wanna try this weapon. Let's refill and let's try it out. Ok. Alright, alright. I mean, now this axe is very expensive. It's even more expensive than the soul mine. What the fuck? It's more expensive than a soul weapon. At this point, like to. Not the market value. Market value can be different, of course. Nobody wants to pay it, then okay. But I'm talking about how much money I spent on this. It was 20k for this, 10k for the tier 1s. No, for the tier 2s. So it was 20, 2 times 10 is 40, and then 4 times 4kk, it's 16. That's the bare minimum. 56kk just on that. Plus, was 8 Phantasmal Axes. So it's like 60 something KK. 60 something, and I failed once. Not counting the slivers, because I don't want to count the slivers because I farmed them. So not a big deal. Okay, let's go. Let's go hunting. No, I want to try it out. Actually want to see the difference because I will try one hunt with this and then one hunt with the other one that I have. Check it out. That's the idea of this. I think I will kill the creatures pretty fast, but okay, let's reset. I have the onslaught. Been a while since I hunted, so I might be a bit rusty. A ver cuántas veces se activa el fatal, porque esto es fatal, va a ser de vez en cuando, eso no va a ser siempre. I mean, I want to see how many times it triggers and when it triggers, if it helps you a lot or not. Because let's be fair, like 170 is nothing. I don't see it triggering too often, that's the only bad thing. It should trigger more for the cost. También hay que ver que esto es un beneficio permanente, ¿no? O sea, es algo que el imbu recuerda que es temporal. O sea, tú lo pagas una vez cada 20 horas. Pero esto ya es permanente. Esto ya lo tiene el arma siempre. A menos que pases el tiro, pues. Pero no sería sano pasarlo. It would make sense to lower the tier of this weapon, right? This is the strongest it can get. Look, it's fatal. There you go, you see the hits. I mean, it's not so easily recognizable because it's dark, but sometimes it goes. And it's permanent, it's a permanent benefit. Which you're paying a lot of money for a permanent benefit, I agree on that. Maybe it should be higher, than 170% for this tier. It could be a bit more. That's my opinion. I don't think it's gonna influence a lot in your hunts. But also, like I said, it's a permanent benefit. But then again, you have better weapons that are cheaper that can give you better benefits. So maybe it's just not a good idea to do this. It's a good damage. You do fatal damage. It's good. But will it matter? I don't know. We will see at the end. Because I will compare. Okay, another one. Look. It's another one. They are so dark that it's not so noticeable. You gotta pay attention. Hay que estar prestándole atención porque es que no salen tan... No son visibles. Mira, ahí está otro más. Ya cuesta verlo. O sea, que los hits fatales sí aparecen, pero no son tan frecuentes. Obviamente el porcentaje te lo dice. Que... Mira, look, another one. And it was a huge hit, like 1k hit. So yeah, they do help. It's a small help. Sometimes not even noticeable, but... It can help you, like, maybe you're not struggling with the mana, but you're not really okay. Well, this will help you keep your mana a bit higher, because you're gonna leech more. I believe the cooldown one, the momentum, gonna be even better, like... Lowering your cooldowns is a huge thing. Like I said, it's permanent, like, that's why you got a value here. It's a permanent bonus. You don't have to pay any other thing. Permanent, that's it. You're gonna have it forever unless you just lower the tier, which would be dumb. I don't advise if you have already a high tier weapon, like on the highest tier available, that you just go and take it away unless it's going for a class 4 item, like soul items, for example, because you got Cobra clubs and it's cheaper. Unless you have a good reason, just don't do it. It's a waste of money. O sea, si no tienes dinero para... O sea, si no tienes un buen motivo, como por ejemplo eso de subir Cobra Club para luego pasárselo a los ítems Soul, pues no vale la pena quitarle los tiros a la arma. No vale la pena. Ok, 15 minutes. Let's kill this one and... We're done. Ok, good. Let's copy the analyzer. Copy. So, what we can see, 7.1 KK hour. Let's change the weapon. Let's copy this and save it. Vamos a guardar este analyzer así como está. Yo les voy diciendo más o menos. Let's try this one now. Reset. And go again. And we will see. Why do I do this? Because doing the math is one thing. And testing the actual weapon is another thing. Because maybe you're just counting. Yeah, it's only 1% damage. But maybe that 1% damage can help you kill slightly faster. And therefore make you save money. That's why I'm trying this. Maybe the 70kk invested, 60 something, 70, I don't know. Maybe that money invested is gonna be 100k profit plus per hour. And maybe eventually you can recover it. Maybe it's just a little bit extra that will help you out every time. Remember, it's permanent. You can always pay it off later on by just profiting some more on each hunt. Okay, it's already 15. Maybe we can try one more, because we did try one more, which was here, exactly here. It's almost the same. It's just a little bit less damage. Copy. There you go. I already have both analyzers. Okay, XP gain a bit higher as expected. 1.8 million. 1.81 is worth mentioning that. And 1.769. So yeah, a bit lower. XP hour, raw XP hour, with the tier 3, 7.127, 7.088 on the tier 0, so a bit lower. XP hour, it's pretty, like, the same, pretty much like the same. We have the raw XP, so let's continue. The loot was a bit higher as well, but what about the supplies? Supplies were almost the same, I mean... Almost the same number. It was 269k. And the difference is just 500 gold. Around that. The balance. I got a little bit more loot with the tier 3. Just a little bit. And the damage, which is what should matter here. It's only 38k more. 38k. It was 1,589 against 1,551. Healing is a little bit less on the tier 3, and that doesn't really matter much. Everything else, I mean, the difference was really expected. It wasn't much. My conclusions. I think it's a lot of money for such a little damage. Is it worth it? Right now, I think it's underwhelming. Eventually, you will benefit from it because it's a permanent thing. You will always have this. It's not like an imbue that you have to spend money to every 20 hours of hunting to gain the benefits. And this is a weapon that I will probably have until a better fire axe weapon comes up, which can be in the next update, which can be in 5 years. You never know. So if you're thinking about getting massive improvements, maybe not Onslaught for you. Just don't try that. I will keep it because I already have it. I don't think it's gonna be worth upgrading every weapon. It's a lot of money, but I want to try the helmet. The helmet looks like can give you a lot of benefits because it's a bonus and you cannot find elsewhere. So it will always be something that will add up. You're not replacing anything. As for the helmets do give you some skills like Terra Helmet. I believe Terra Helmet is ideal because you can do Mana Leech, which is a must for most helmets. And you can just add this momentum into it. About the Ruse is tricky because it's like a dodge but works against everything. Because it's just like 8%. You could see it as a defense spray, like a very low defense spray. I would like to see it like that, but I don't know if it's gonna be like that in the actual hunt. We will have to try it out. My plan is to go with an Elven Mail, but it will take some time probably. And but yeah, I want to try the helmet. The helmet looks promising. And well, this was the test. I will explain in Spanish now. A ver, las diferencias entre los números son muy pequeñas. Es verdad que con el tier te ganas un poco más de experiencia ahora. Es un poco más de loot, es un poco más. O sea, estamos hablando de diferencias pequeñas. 10k de diferencia de loot. En la experiencia ahora son como unos 50k de experiencia. Ahora, o sea, no es nada. O sea, 7.127 contra 7.088. No es casi nada. En cuanto al daño, pues hay unos 1.589.000 por un lado, por el de tier 3. Y por el otro lado, de tier 0, 1.551.000. Una diferencia que no se nota casi. Pero recuerda, es que esto, la probabilidad es de 1.70. 1.70. Ah. Beneficios permanentes, eso es lo que tú tienes que valorar aquí, porque no tienes que estar inmoviendo a cada rato, o sea, cada 20 horas. Es un arma que ya te va a durar así, a menos que le bajes el tir, cosa que yo no recomiendo en absoluto, porque ¿para qué lo vas a hacer? O sea, pierdes dinero allí, o sea, es mejor subir otra arma. A estos puntos tan bajos es mejor subir otra cosa que estar cambiándole los tiros. Y nada, yo pienso, en mi opinión, que el Onslaught es un atributo que no rinde como debería rendir, debería dar un poco más. Se siente un poco la diferencia en cuanto a la comodidad de la home, pero es que un poco, es algo que mucha gente no va a notar. Yo, cuando tiraba un fatal, se notaba que el char como que permite descansar un poco más, porque es que drenas un poco más de vida, un poco más de mana, entonces siempre andas como más tranquilo en ese sentido. Pero como digo, no es algo muy notorio, es algo que apenas está ahí. Pero sí es cierto que aumentas daño, es cierto. A aquellos que quieren ir a más, porque, qué sé yo, los high level, 1800. Estamos hablando de gente que tiene mucho dinero y que quiere daño porque se basan en... quieren experiencia. Y para ganar experiencia, pues tienen que pegar. Pues yo creo que lo van a buscar, lo van a intentar. Pero yo personalmente creo que me iría por el helmet primero. A ver, pruebo el daño porque el daño es lo más llamativo. Pero yo creo, quiero intentar otro helmet. Terra helmet suena muy bien porque tiene skill y puedes poner el Mana Leech. Tiene buenas protecciones y puede llegar a ofrecerte una buena característica que es el cooldown. O sea, cooldown reduction. Eso no lo tienes en ningún lado. Eso solamente lo vas a tener ahí. Es un atributo que es diferente y puede sumar bastante. Y lo quiero probar. Vamos a tener que esperar a subir otra cosa. Obviamente ya luego al final de que yo tenga todo tier 3, lo quiero probar así con tier 3 todo y ver la diferencia real. Si es que hay algo que que de verdad impacta o no. O sea, si es simplemente tirar el dinero. Yo creo que ha sido un buen análisis. Sí me gasté un dinero, pero yo creo que vale la pena gastárselo porque... A ver, tú siempre puedes esperar que alguien lo haga, pero yo quería hacerlo pues primero. Para darme cuenta yo de si vale la pena o no. O sea, no esperar a que alguien lo haga para yo luego ver si vale la pena o no. Porque igual luego los precios se disparan porque resulta que vale la pena. Ya lo probé. Ya tengo mi arma. Yo ya sé mi fantasmal, pues. No la voy a vender. No voy a venderla. No voy a bajarla de tir. No voy a hacer nada con ella. Tenga que ver con deshacerme yo de esa arma. Ya la tengo.